Hi guys, this is Tarun from Testing Gyan. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the industry's best and standard practices when you're working on a Git project. So let us start. While working on Git project, it is very important to follow some standard or good practices to avoid any kind of conflicts, confusion, or problems in your project. Okay. Few of those best practices are: keep your team informed in advance whatever the change you're going to make in whatever the file you're going to make those changes, okay, so that your team know in advance that this is something which you are doing and they should not touch it, so that you will not see any conflicts in the future, okay. And after that, as soon as once you are done with the changes and you pushed your changes to some remote repository code base, your team should be informed and they should take the pull right away after your push, so that their local code is in total sync with your remote code. Now what I meant by that, let us see. Consider the scenario: either you or your one of your team member is working on some file and they are making their changes. So the first thing is, like, they should keep the team informed that they are doing some changes in this file. Once they are done with the changes, the next thing is to inform the team as soon as they are made the changes in the remote code. Okay, for example, if I'm working on this test class, okay, I made some changes in my working directory and then I pushed those changes. Okay, to replicate that scenario, what I will do, I will directly make the change in the remote code. Let's say I did one more CISO here, okay, and then I did the commit changes. So this is just to replicate the scenario where I worked on my local code and then I pushed my changes. Okay, now as soon as I did this change, my team should be informed before this that I am making changes to this file, and after this that I have pushed my changes to this remote code. And as soon as I did that, my complete team should be informed and they should take the pull immediately, so that their local code base is in total sync with the remote code. So in order to do that, I will take the pull in my local system. Okay, you can see whatever the changes are made in the remote repository are now here in my this system. So this way, my local code or my team members' local code is in total sync with the remote code and they will not see any conflicts by doing the push and pull operations. So this is the first few best practices. Then the other best practice is to use the branching in your project specific to the users. Like, you can have multiple branch allocated to different users in your project. Okay, if number of users are very high, then that can be avoided because that will create branches unnecessarily. Okay, you can have the branches specific to some feature of your application. For example, you're working on a banking application and currently you are working on the internet banking functionality, and so you can have a branch specific to that functionality. So you can have a branch specific to features, specific to individuals, or some other criteria you can have. Okay, and why we need branching? So that your main code branch or your final code, your master branch, should be kept separately from the branches. Okay, and once you have made the changes in your branch, then those changes should be merged with the final branch after the proper review, so that your final code should not have any impact on it. It should have the right data in it. So you should use the branching and keep your main code branch separate from the normal branches. Okay, and how we can do that, let us see. So here you can see, like, this is my branch. Let's consider this is my user specific branch and I am working on my this branch only. Okay, so let me make some change. I made some change in my code base and then I pushed the changes into my branch. Save all. My change. Commit and push. credentials. Okay, so my changes are pushed. So these changes are pushed to my branch. Currently they are not merged with my main code branch. Okay, so now let us see how we can do that. What is the good practice we should follow to do that? So once you have made the change, you should go to your remote branch and then you should see like your changes are done properly and are being reflected here. Yeah, my change is reflected here. After that, in order to merge my this branch code with the main branch code, the my current branch is test branch. This is my branch, sorry, I looked into the master branch. So yeah, my change is here. Okay, and in order to merge my this test branch with my main branch, which is my master branch, which is having the final code in it, what I will do, I will raise a pull request. Okay, so pull request is something that you are asking for permission to merge your branch with this main branch. Okay, so you can also add approvers to the pull request, so that once you raise any pull request, it will go to some approver. They will go through your code, they will check if there is something wrong, they will inform it to you, they will cancel your pull request. Okay, if they find it like change is fine, perfect, then they will approve your pull request and then your change will be merged with the final code. So this is a standard practice which should be followed whenever you're working with a Git project. So let me create a pull request here. I will create a new pull request. Okay, and I will say merge my test branch with my master branch. Okay, once I do that, GitHub will automatically compare those branches for you and it will give you okay sign, able to merge. If there is any conflict, it will inform you that there is some conflict which should be resolved first. Okay, once you do that, create the pull request. Currently there are no reviewers, no assignees, nothing is assigned, but you can add a reviewers while creating a pull request. Okay, or this is something which is being controlled by your admins. They will do that. As soon as you create a pull request, it will go to the assigned approvers, reviewers. Okay, and you can give some comment to my pull request, and after that click on create pull request. So you can see, as soon as I clicked on create pull request, a pull request is being created. Okay, and after that you will see this branch has no conflicts with the base branch. That is, my test branch is not having any conflict by main conflict with my main branch. So my pull request is complete. After that I will say merge pull request and I will say confirm the merge. Okay, so you can see pull request successfully merged and closed. So this way my test branch is being merged with my main branch, and this is the standard Git practice to merge the your local branches with your remote branches and then your remote individual branch with your main branch, so that at the end you have a one final code base which everyone can refer to. Okay, so that's all about the standard Git practice. I hope you guys are able to understand. In case of any doubts, please let us know over the video comments. We will try our best to answer those queries. Thank you. We'll be right back.